problems based on nth term of an AP, that is arithmetic progression, in terms of sum to n terms and sum to n minus 1 terms. So here we are going to discuss few problems which are based upon the nth term of an AP in terms of sum of n terms of an AP and as well as the sum of n minus 1 term of an AP, which is given by means of Tn. The nth term is given by means of sum of n terms minus sum of n minus 1 terms. So here we are going to deal problems based upon this formula in an advanced level. So here the formula for finding the nth term of an AP is of a plus n minus 1 into d, whereas sum of n terms when a, the common difference d, the a the first term and the common difference d is known, is given by means of s of n is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Then now here the problem starts now. So whereas in this problem, if the sum of first n terms, if the sum of first n terms is given by 3n square minus 2n. So here sum of first n terms, or in other words s of n, is given by means of 3n square minus 2n. Then we have to find out AP. So here we have to find out the arithmetic progression. Find AP, that is nothing but the arithmetic progression, and also the 20th term. So here 20th term is nothing but the t of 20. So you have to find out the 20th term, that is t20, and as well as the sequence of arithmetic progression. Then now the solution starts. So in our solution, as per problem, the sum of first n terms is given by means of 3n square minus 2n. So here as per problem, sum of first n terms is given, so here that equals to, is given by means of 3n square minus 2n. So here 3n square minus 2n. So here we are going to suppose sum of n terms as s of n. So that implies sum to n terms is denoted by means of the symbol, that is s of n, is given by means of 3n square minus 2n. Then the next logical step will be of, since s of n is equals to 3n square minus 2n as per the problem, at n is equals to 1, so in the first case we are going to substitute n as 1. Then now the next logical step will be of, that implies s of, so n is replaced by means of 1, so s of 1 is equals to 3 into, so n replaced by means of once again 1, so it is n square, so 1 whole square minus 2 into, so there is of into symbol in between 2 and n, so here 2 into n, so 2 into n value is of 1 again. Then now that implies, so 3 into 1 square, so 1 repeatedly multiplied twice, so 1 into 1 is of 1, minus 2 1s is of 2. So that implies, so 3 1s is of 3 minus 2, whereas that equals to 3 minus 2 is of 1. So in this manner, so I got, so s of 1 is equals to 1. Then s of n is given by means of the condition, that is 3n square minus 2n as per the problem. So here we have to replace now in the second case by means of n equals to 2. So here we have replaced n by means of 1, so I got s of 1 as 1. So now at n is equals to 2, so that implies s of, when n is replaced by means of 2, so I will be getting s2, sum of 2 terms equals to 3 into, so n again replaced by means of 2, so it will be of 2 whole square, because it is of n square minus 2 into n value is of 2, so it must be substituted as 2. So that implies, so 3 into 2 square, 2 repeatedly multiplied twice, 2 into 2 is of 4, minus here also it is of 2, bracket indicates into 2 into 2 is of 4. So that implies 3 fourths is of 12 minus 4. So to simplify further, the next logical step will be of, 4 is of negative and 12 is of positive. So here to simplify, so here plus of minus is minus, we have to subtract the greater minus least, that is 12 minus 4 is of 8. So here to assess the sign of this 8, so we have to see the greater one among 12 and 4. Since 12 is greater than 4, 12 sign is of positive, therefore 8 assess the sign of positive. So in this manner I got s2 equals to 8. S of 2, the sum of 2 terms is of 8. Then now in the third case, I have to suppose, so n as 3 in the third case. So here the next logical step, since sum of n terms is given by means of 3n square minus 2n as per the problem. Then now, so here I'm going to assume, so here at n is equals to 3 in the third case, so that implies s of, so n replaced by means of 3, so s of 3, that is the sum of all the 3 terms, t1 plus t2 plus t3, so I'll be getting the value as 3 into n value as 3, so here substitute the n as 3, then but it must be squared because it is of n square, minus 2 into n value is of 3, that implies, so 3, bracket indicates into, so 3 square, or in other words 3 into 3, or in other words 3 repeatedly multiplied twice, so 3 square is of 9, 3 3 is of 9, minus 2 3 is of 6, then now the next logical step will be of, that implies 3 9 is of 27, minus 6, to simplify further, the next logical step will be of, so here 6 is of negative and the 27 is of positive, so here plus of minus is minus, so we have to subtract, that is greater minus least, so 27 minus 6 is of 21, to assess the sign here, 27 is greater than 6, 27 is of positive, therefore 21 assess the sign of positive, so in this manner I got, so s of 3 as positive 21, that is 21, the latter s of n is equals to 3n square minus 2n is the condition which is given to us, so here based upon this condition I am going to find out the sum of the 4 terms, by supposing or by assuming n as 4. When n is equals to 4, then that implies the condition will be of. So s of, when n is replaced by means of 4, then this will be of s of 4, because n replaced by means of 4, that equals to 3 into n replaced by means of 4, it is of 4, but it is of square, that is 4 square minus 2 into n replaced by means of 4, so 2 into 4. The next logical step will be of, so that implies, so 3 into, so 4 square, 4 repeatedly multiplied twice, 4 into 4 itself, that is 16, minus 2 fourths is of 8. So that implies, 16 threes is of 48, with positive sign, then now 8 is of negative. So you have to simplify further, the next logical step will be of. So you have plus of minus is minus, let us subtract 48 minus 8, because greater minus least is of 40. So to assess the sign of 40, 48 is greater than 8, 48 sign is of positive, therefore 40 assess the sign of positive. So in this manner I got S4. So S of 4 is equals to 40. So S of 4 equals to 40. So in this manner I got, so S of 1 as 1, then S of 2 as 8. S of 3 as 21 and S of 4 as 40. So here the next logical step will be of. So hence S of 1 is equals to 1, then S of 2 is equals to 8, S of 3 is equals to 21 and 40. So S of 3 is of 21 and S of 4 is equals to 40. So in this manner I got S of 1 as 1, S of 2 as 8, S of 3 as 21 and S of 4 as 40. Then now, so here we know in order to get the first term, so formula is of T of n, in order to get the nth term, so we have to subtract, that is Sn minus S of n minus 1. So sum of n minus 1 terms must be subtracted from sum of n terms in order to get the nth term. So based upon this formula, in order to get the first term, in order to get the first term, so n must be replaced by means of 1. So n is equals to 1, then that equals to, so S of n replaced by means of 1 minus S 1 minus 1, because n is replaced by means of 1, 1 minus 1. So here, so that implies S of 1 minus S of 1 minus 1 is of 0. So S of 0 is negligible. So we can strike off this, I mean S of 0. So that implies S of 1. So here in this manner I got, so here therefore T1, the first term is nothing but the sum of 1 terms. So here sum of 1 terms is nothing but equals to 1. So in this manner I say I got the first term as 1. Then now T of n is equals to nth term is equals to S of n minus S of n minus 1 is the formula for finding the nth term based upon the sum of n terms and as well as the sum of n minus 1 terms. So in order to get the second term, so here at n is equals to 2, so now let us replace, so n by means of 2, so here t, n replaced by means of 2, that is we are going to get the value of t2, that is the second term, s of n, so here n replaced by means of 2 minus s of n replaced again by means of 2, that is of minus 1, 2 minus 1, so that implies s of 2 written as it is minus s of 2 minus 1 is of 1, so s2 minus s1 gives us the second term. Then now, so that implies s2 as per the problem sum of 2 terms, so here s2 is of 8 and s1 is of 1, s2 is of 8 minus S1 is of 1, so that implies, so 8 minus 1 is of 7, so in this manner I got, so the second term T2 as, the second term as 7. In order to get the third term, so here the condition that is given is, in order to get the nth term, so we have to subtract, that is S of n minus 1 from S of n, that is S of n minus S of n minus 1 will give us the nth term, that is Tn, or the general term. of an AP. Then now, so now let us replace n by means of 3 in order to get the third term. So here, then the next logical step will be of T of n replaced by means of 3. So I'm going to get the third term, then that is equals to S of n. S of n is of 3. So S of 3 minus S of n replaced by means of 3. So 3 minus 1. That implies S3 written as it is minus S of 3 minus 1 is of 2. So that implies S of 3 as per the problem. So we got S of 3 as 21 and S of 2 as 8. 21 and 8. So here S of 3 is of 21 and S of 2 is of 8. So by to simplify further, so 8 is of negative and 21 is of positive. To simplify further here, plus of minus is minus. Let us subtract. 21 minus 8 is of 13. So here, to assess the sign of this 13, so here 21 is greater than 8. So 21 sign is of positive. Therefore, it assesses the sign of 13, assesses the sign of positive. So in this manner, I got. So S of 3, so T of 3, the third term. So T3, that is the third term, is equals to 13. So here, hence, the first term is of 1, second term is of 7, and the third term is of 13. So here, hence the series was the sequence of an AP is 1, the first term, and the second term is of 7, and the third term is of 13. And similarly and so on. Then now, since T1 is of 1 and the T2, the second term is of 7, the third term is of 13, so let us write. So here T1, the first term denoting by means of A, is equals to 1. In order to get the common difference, denoting by means of D, so we can write it as T2 minus T1, so or T3 minus T2. So here then the next logical step will be of, that implies T2 is of 7, minus T1 is of 1, that equals to T3 is of 13 minus T2 is of 7. So that implies 7 minus 1 is of 6, then that equals to 13 minus 7 is also of 6. So in this manner we got D is equals to 6. Here difference is common, so it's here T2 minus T1, the difference between the first two terms is of 6 and the next two terms, that is second term and third term, is also of 6. Therefore the difference is common throughout the series, hence it is under the arithmetic progression. Therefore, the series will come under the arithmetic progression. Say here, therefore, the common difference, that is denoting by means of D, value is of 6. So in this manner, I got the A value as 1, that is the first term, and the common difference D as 6. But as per the problem, we have to find out the 20th term. So here we know the general term, but the gen term, that is the general term of an AP or the arithmetic progression, is given by means of, so here that is general term, it is denoting by means of the Tn, or the nth term is given by means of A plus n minus 1 into D. Let us block it. So here in order to find out the 20th term, so here n must be replaced by means of 20, so that we will be getting T20, which is the required one. So here at n is equals to 20, then the next logical step will be of, so here T of, so here n replaced by means of 20 here. So n must be replaced by means of 20. So here T of 20 equals to A plus n minus 1 into D. So A value is of, so A is of 1 and the D is of 6. So here let us write. So here A value is of 1 and the D value is of 6. Then now by replacing in the formula, that is T of n is equals to A plus n minus 1 into D. That is the general term of an arithmetic progression. So here n is replaced by means of 20. So T20 equals to A. So A value is of 1 plus n again. So here n is replaced by means of 20. That is 20 minus 1 into D. So D is of 6. So that implies 1 plus 20 minus 1 is nothing but 19 multiplied with 6 within the brackets. Then now that implies 1 plus 19 into 6. So 19 must be multiplied with 6. So here 6 9s is of 54 with carry 5. 6 1s is of 6 plus 5 is of 11. That is of 114. So here 19 6 is of 114. Then now the next logical step will be of. That implies by adding up 1 is of positive and 114 is also of positive. So here plus into plus is of plus by adding 114 and 1. So you will be getting 115 with positive, because 114 is greater than 1 with positive sign. Therefore 115 assesses the sign of positive. So in this manner I got. So here T20, that is the 20th term of the series, is given by means of 115.